Good evening, friends. This is Dr. Bharat Shah, Director at Institute of Renal Sciences, Global Hospital, Mumbai, and Consultant Nephrologist at Reliance Foundation Hospital. Today, I am going to tell you about kidney transplant. I have explained to you earlier that when the kidneys have permanently failed, it is called as end-stage kidney disease, and for all practical purposes, these kidneys are dead, and it is not possible for a person to survive. For these people, dialysis and transplant are the only options, and because transplant is a complete treatment, it is a far superior form of renal replacement therapy. Now, for transplantation to be performed, it is important that a person is in overall good health except for his end-stage kidney disease. All other systems of his body should be good enough so that there are no complications of other system after transplant. For a transplant to be performed, it is useful to have a donor who has a similar or a compatible blood group, but with today's advances, it is also possible to perform transplant when the blood group is incompatible. For transplant, the kidney can come from a living donor because each one of us has been provided by two kidneys, and it is perfectly fine for a person to lead a normal life with one kidney. So a living person can donate one of the two kidneys. As per the Indian Transplant Act, the donor has to be a closely related family member. If that is not possible, one can hope of getting a kidney from a person who is dead. Now here, it is important to understand that when we talk of death, it is not the cardiac death that we often understand, but we are talking of brain death. This understanding is important because when someone's heart stops beating, all parts of the body stop getting blood supply and they cannot be used for transplant. On the other hand, when someone is brain dead and supported on ventilator, the heart continues to beat for some time and all parts of the body continue to get blood supply. And that is how one brain dead person can provide two kidneys and help two patients with end-stage kidney disease. In kidney transplant, the two kidneys that have failed are left in their original position, nothing is done for them. The new kidney is implanted in the lower part of the abdomen on the right or the left side, the right iliac fossa or the left iliac fossa. The connection between the artery and the vein is established, and then a new ureter opening is made into the bladder. After a living donor kidney transplant, one can see urine coming out immediately after the anastomosis has been established. When we do a kidney transplant, it is important for us to suppress the immune system because the immune system of the recipient will try to reject the transplanted kidney because it is foreign to his body. This raises two important issues of transplant. If you do not suppress the immune system adequately, this kidney can be rejected. On the other hand, if you suppress the immune system too much, one becomes more prone to infection. And therefore, it is very important that one delicately balances the immunosuppression dose in such a way that it is neither too less and allow rejection to happen, nor is it too more that infection develops. The results of transplant today are extremely good. Today, 1 year survival is close to 95 to 97%, 3 year survival is 90%, 5 year survival is 85%, and 10 year survival 60 to 70%. And therefore, all patients who are suitable for transplant must consider transplant as the form of renal replacement therapy. It is a complete treatment. Once the new kidney has been transplanted, hemoglobin improves, bones become stronger, and all the entire function of the kidney is provided to the patient. So the quality of life is far superior. I hope I have been able to explain in this limited time about kidney transplantation. If you have any questions, please feel free to write to lybrate.com and I'll be happy to answer all your questions.